Hello and welcome to another edition of All About Apps from the Cleveroad Studio. Today we are discussing app store optimization strategies that will let your mobile app thrive. Let's talk about the differences between Google Play Store and Apple App Store. There is no denying that Google Play Store and Apple App Store are two titans competing for influence and the loyalty of consumers and developers in the world today. Both stores started out in 2008. Google Play is orientated towards the Android audience, while Apple App Store is optimized for owners of iOS-based devices. The most common numbers used to compare the two stores are the number of available apps and the total number of downloads. According to statistics, Google Play outnumbers Apple App Stores both in terms of available apps and the total number of downloads. However, Apple's app revenue is about 70% higher than Google. But customers are not usually interested in revenue figures or how successful the store is. Their main aim is to find and download apps in a comfortable and easy way. App owners and app developers are interested in product growth and popularity. For that reason, app marketing and app store optimization is a prime area of our research. It's hard to tell which store has better results due to app store optimization, but we can easily compare the differences between them. The name of the app plays an important role in the success of your app. When you make up a name, you should create a catchword, which includes the theme of the app. In Google Play Store, you have 55 different characters available for naming your app, while App Store provides 255. However, you'd be better off using 70 or fewer. Keywords in the name can be grouped with tag words. Keywords have more influence in Google Play Store compared with Apple App Store. In company with the name, your app icon will also impress customers. An illustrative and aesthetic icon can really improve your visibility in Apple App Store. A description of your app should be written in clear English and provide the most information in the first two sentences. The best variant is two abstracts, followed by five or six differentiating features. Google Play gives a 4,000 character limit on descriptions, which should include keywords, meaningful sentences, and an imaginative vocabulary. A description for App Store can be less ISO focused and more orientated on attracting customers. As for screenshots, it's recommended that you publish as many screenshots as possible on your app page. The limitation for Google is 8 screenshots, while Apple provides room for only 5. Reviews are a very important part of off-page ISO. It's the key which unlocks your customers' hearts. But don't try to fill your app page with fake positive reviews. Unlike Apple App Store, Google Play lets you answer reviews written by developers. ASO is not limited to only these points. It's a complex process aimed at ensuring your customers' loyalty and therefore your app's success and profitability. It should be said that Google Play Store is easier for an app to enter. Apple has very tough restrictions and demands for app approval in the App Store. Developers find it difficult and stressful to deal with some grey areas in the acceptance criteria. It takes about 3 or 4 weeks of thorough preparation and actual submission. What's more, both stores officially castigate developers for infractions of the rules, which should be strictly followed. Pornography and scenes of realistic violence are banned by stores without exception. Stores go over the top, barring even a hint of nudity. Acts of piracy are also not allowed in stores. Rules forbid sharing of illegal content, such as copies of movies, music, books, etc. Next, any attempt to get around the payment system is restricted and under serious control in both stores. One more method, which is very popular among developers, but categorically disallowed by both stores, is driving up the number of comments. To stimulate customers, you should choose only loyal customers and ask them to comment when they feel positive about their app experience. Apart from the aforementioned, every store has its own restrictions. The Apple App Store doesn't allow any imitations of app mechanics or to publish or promote any App Store rival. Google Play strictly bans the use of push messages to promote advertising. Apple App Store and Google Play work differently. Of course, some parts are similar or perform the same functions. Both have their own pros and cons. Basically, Apple and Google have both managed to create an excellent ecosystem for modern mobile platforms. This is why they are global market leaders. The actual choice of leader is up to you. Well, that's about all for today. If you want to read the full article, then visit the blog page of the Cleveroad website. See you again soon on another All About Apps.